I can relax now because it was like really intense performance to me, and also an intense program. So the happiness I feel today is definitely different. The sonata, especially the second movement, it's quite challenging for my hand, you know, really open, really strong. And sometimes I feel like they will not make it, but they did. They made it. Yeah, I think that was the challenge for me because I have to be focused on my body as well when I play it. You have to, you know, save energies and to use them in the right way. You know, when you are on stage, sometimes it's easy to give too much all at once, right? Challenge was to save energies and use them as I needed. And I think I did. I'm happy to be able to overcome my challenges. You know, in mazurkas, I never stop discovering things. I think they are the epitome of Chopin's music. I have such strong bond with mazurkas. I love them. It may seem easy to say I love them, but I really do love them. I used to listen to Rubinstein City. Listen to it so much. Like, it was going and going and going. And to me, you know, mazurkas, especially Rubinstein's ones, are able to bring me somewhere else. I don't know where, it depends on the atmosphere of the mazurkas I'm gonna play, but you know, sometimes I can feel I'm like on the mountains, I'm on the countryside. There are so many stories behind mazurkas that I cannot really start to tell what I'm thinking about, but I think to play them after the Polonaise Fantasie and before the sonata, for me it was magical. I have so many feelings about the mazurkas, so you know, I was waiting for them many years ago, before even the last time I took part to the competition, so it was maybe 2010. I was studying with Marian Mika, who is a Polish professor who lives in Italy. He told me, like, Leonora, you seem to not really understand what you are playing in mazurkas, right? And I was like, maestro, of course, I mean, I've never been in Poland, I've never listened to any traditional Polish music, I don't know anything about it. Me, okay, so let's dance. And he like grabbed me from the bench and started showing me how to dance the oberek. I was like, wow, so that's how it feels. Nice. And then I went back to the piano and something changed. I think something happened like within myself about the going in depth of the music. When I was 18, I was already mature. I still have had to discover many things. Of course, I mean, I still have to discover so many things, but I think the main change I was hoping for, was to be able really to go in depth much more about the feelings, about the emotions, but not just happy, sad, like so many different emotions. And our job is, like actors, we have to feel them in order to let people feel what you want, right? That's why when I'm on stage now, I do many more expressions, my face. I cannot control them, they come now. I try really to impersonate what I'm playing. I think this was the biggest change.